I hope you all will. In this video or tutorial, I'm gonna talk about how to set up a still life. Yay! Setting up a still life. Woohoo! Yes, I know you guys are so excited. Yay! Alright, you guys. So, the first thing that I am gonna talk about is the reason why I'm doing this video is because I have drawn and painting students, and because we are working remotely, unfortunately, you have to set up your own still life. Boo-hoo. But you will learn a lot. You just don't have me there setting it up for you. So this is what I'm going to talk about in the video. So I'm going to start with my setup. So I can only talk about my own setup, but I'm just going to give you some tips, may help you, or you may figure out how to set it up on your own, at your home or in your room, wherever you're at doing your artwork and doing your homework assignments. So what I did is I actually went to Home Depot and I bought, this is actually a decorative shelf that I bought. So I bought a decorative shelf from Home Depot because I wanted something that I can adjust, move around, that's light in weight. So I just went ahead and just bought a decorative shelf, and it's working out fine. So what I did is I did have it on the wall at one point in time, but my walls are very weak in my studio, unfortunately. I'm not happy about that. But what I did, and I decided to do, I got creative. I have my table, well, not my table, my decorative shelf, sitting under a step stool, which this small step stool is on top of my table in my studio. So it's been working out pretty well with that. I'm still able to move it around wherever I want it, and I'm pretty happy about that. So another thing that I did when it comes to my setup is I like to have kind of, I like to play with my backgrounds a bit when it comes to like color and things of that nature. So what I always do is I'll put down some paper, but I have, right now I have gray paper. So I have a Value 5 gray paper that's on the foreground, and I'm sorry, the table ground, as well as I have pinned up gray paper on the wall as well. So what I like about doing this, especially when we get into color, you can definitely have some really fun colors in your backgrounds or on your table grounds. That's what I love about having paper. It's just really fun to do, to add some pop of color to whatever you're starting to draw. So you guys, that's pretty much my setup and how I work. So just remember, you can always buy a decorative shelf. You can always set up your still life just on your table. You just want to make sure you have it in either in front of you or to the side of you, whether you are, if you're right-handed, maybe to the left. If you're left-handed, maybe to the right of you. You just want to make sure that you have it there with you. You also want to make sure that your still life is at your eye level. You don't want to have a still life and you're standing up and you're looking down at it. It's going to kind of change your perspective in a way. Or you're looking completely up at it. You don't want to do that neither. I would suggest, basically for beginners, you know, just keep your still life at your eye level. That definitely does help a lot. So another thing that I'm going to talk about, as you can see here, I have, wait for it, 5 objects. Yay, 5 objects. So I have 5 objects here. And I'm going to talk just a little bit about just composition in a way. An easy way to think about composition when you're composing your still life. You just want to think about, you have a foreground, so that's the things that are closest to you. You want to make sure you have a middle ground, which is the things that are in the middle of your composition. You also want to make sure you have a background. So you want to make sure you have things in the background as well. So that's very important to keep in mind. That's one of the quick and easiest way to deal with composition. Another thing you want to make sure that you're thinking about when you're setting up your composition, you want to make sure you have highs and lows. And I think those are basically called introverts. But highs and lows, meaning you want things to be high up in your composition. Things to be possibly low, things to be high, things to be low. That gives something a viewer can look at it, and it'll be a lot more interesting than having things just kind of straight across. They're all the same height. Having some highs and lows definitely help the composition out a lot. So those are one of the things that you definitely want to think about. You also want to think about scale and proportions. So you want to think about having things that are smaller in proportions, or odd in proportions, big in proportions. And you also want to think of scale, having something that is big or tall next to something that is short. So you want to kind of think about just proportions, having things that are different in proportions, also having things that are different in scale. That definitely helps with just having an interesting composition. Another thing that you want to think about as well when you're setting up your composition, you want to think about having objects that are of different local values. So we have yellow objects, which falls on the higher end of the value scale. It's probably like a value 2. I have a pink little bunny. I think it's a bunny. A pink bunny that's there. We have some grapes that are red. So these are going to fall more in mid-tones. So we're probably going to be looking at a value 5 that's here. Probably like a value 4 or 3 that's there. And then of course I have something that's here that's black. So we know that's a value 10, or, you know, depending on your scale, value 5, something like that. So those are things that you definitely want to think about when you're setting up your composition. Another thing that you want to think about when you're setting up your composition, you want to think about your content. So what do you want to draw? That's something that's very, very important. Do you have a storyline for it? Are you just grabbing a bunch of items and putting them together? That works. That definitely works too. That's what I just did. You can always think it through. And if you have a storyline or if you have a theme, you can definitely work with that. That definitely does help. Another thing that you want to think about, and I'm going to talk just a little bit more about, thinking about some do's and some don'ts. Okay, so let's say I take my lovely, trusty, beautiful composition apart. Yay. The one thing you want to always have in your composition, or at least think about, is overlaps. So you don't want to have a composition that's like this and like this. Guess what? We have no overlaps. So overlaps always make compositions very, very interesting. So that means you want something, at least something, to be in front of one thing. You want something to be in back and in front, something like this. And I'm going to turn it the opposite way. So if you can kind of get some overlaps happening, that definitely helps the composition. So like I said, you don't want everything to be lined up like this, just straight across, although we do have intervals. We have highs, lows, lows. You know, we do have intervals and not straight across. But you definitely just want to make sure that you think of a composition that makes sense. So having overlaps, having highs and lows, those intervals, thinking of a foreground, middle ground, and background, you could definitely produce a lot of good composition. So one is not interesting enough at all, unfortunately. But you just want to make sure you're thinking about that. So if I wanted to compose this, all of these items, let's say we try something different, I like to start with the background, because, you know, you're moving from back to foreground. That definitely helps. And then I kind of always think about, okay, highs and lows, how do I want to set this up? I can always take my little bunny that's here, little cute little bunny, and then I also want to, let's say my cup or my grapes can be here, because we want to make sure we have some overlapping. And then I can have that there, so we kind of have a middle ground that's here. I have a beautiful foreground. We have overlaps that are happening. We also have some really good negative spacing, so you want to pay attention to those shapes as well. We got highs and lows, so you can see something that's high, some low things. So those are things that you definitely want to think about. So I know that some of my projects, you guys, are you probably are dealing with between 5 to 3 objects. You might even deal with more than that. But let's say we have 3 objects. And I'm going to change out my little objects that are here. We have our cute little white unicorn. Aw, it's so cute. All right. And I also have this here. So there's a lot of ways that we can set this up on our 3 objects. Because we have some pretty good highs and lows that are happening, I can definitely possibly set it up in this way. So I can have a foreground, a middle ground. Also, I have my little yellow box in the background. So I can definitely do that, or I can move it around. Let's say we take our unicorn, and we can place that there. And we have some overlapping. We still have a foreground, middle ground, background that's happening. So there's a lot of different ways that you could definitely do that. Even if, let's say this, we do a composition that's like this. Although there's not a lot of overlapping, but you do got something that's sitting on top of something, we can always move that back, so that's going to give us some overlapping. So we still have a background. We don't really have a foreground, but we do have a middle ground. But this still is a really good composition, even just having 3 objects. So it's really, really good to really think about, okay, what I'm going to do, how I'm going to place things, how do I want things to look. All of that stuff is very important when it comes to composition. So if I had, let's say, 4 objects. Oop, dropping stuff, not good. All right, let's say we have our cute little bunny. I think it's a bunny. Hopefully it's a bunny. And I'm going to push him a little further back. And I want to have something in the foreground. Got some good overlapping happening. So if you look at it, I do have some overlapping. So you want to look at this. I have something in the foreground, something in the middle ground, something in the background that's giving me some space that's there. And if you think about it, I have things with different proportions. I also have things that, when I think about scale, I have things that are really big, really small, some things on the medium size. So you can think of all these different compositions, and the one thing that you just want to make sure you're thinking about is foreground, middle ground, and background. Those are kind of the basics. You also want to make sure that you're thinking about how you're setting it up, first and foremost. You also want to make sure you're thinking about highs and lows, scale and proportions. Do you see overlapping? Do you have different scales of things, different proportions? Do those things have different proportions? You want to think of all of that stuff. All of that, it's very, very important. Of course, content is important. What are you going to draw? Do you want to have a theme? Do you want to not have a theme? Do you just want to have a bunch of random stuff, kind of like what I got going on here? You can definitely do that as well. So you guys, I hope this helps. This is very, very basic stuff. I want to keep it basic. I just want you guys to at least have an idea of how to set up your still life in a basic way. I don't want you to get too crazy with it, because I haven't gone over composition yet. And that would definitely help you with setting up your still life as well. So I will see you guys, yay, in the next video. And also I will see you guys in class. So yeah. So if you like this video, go ahead and subscribe, and also push the like button. And I just want to say thank you so much to those who are watching my videos. I hope that these videos help when it comes to drawing, painting, any of those things. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.